A very good day to all of you. In today's class, you will practice what you have learned in the previous class and will also type out a paragraph. But before we do all that, can you tell what you have learned in the previous class? Come, let us revise what we learned in the earlier class. Can you tell why do we use option new in Writer and what is the shortcut command for this? We use the option new to open a new page. And the shortcut command for new is Ctrl plus N. What happens with the open submenu and what is the shortcut command for it? We use open to open the files we have saved on our computer. The shortcut command for open is Ctrl plus O. Can you tell the difference between save and save as? By using save, we can save our files on the computer at any location and with any name that we may want to give our file. When required, we can later open our file and see it. Using the Save As option, we can see our saved file's name and location, and if we like, we can change both the name and the location. Can you tell why we use Export as PDF and also give the full form of PDF? With the option of Export as PDF, we can change our Writer file into a PDF file, which makes our file safe. No user can do any editing on our file, which means that no one can make changes to your file. A user can only read your file. And the full form of PDF is Portable Document Format. Now, all of you switch on your computers and open the Writer file. If you have a problem, watch the video and learn from it. Today, we learn a new method to open files by watching a video. Firstly, you will need to locate on the desktop the file which is named as an OpenOffice file or search for its symbol as is being shown in the video. Now, you should also look for a similar symbol on your desktop. Take your pointer there and then using the left button of the mouse or the touchpad, double click on the symbol. On doing this, just as is being shown in the video, a window will open up in front of you. You will see many components of OpenOffice being shown in the window. This window is called the Quick Start window. Here, to select the text document, just once click on it with the left button. This will open your OpenOffice Writer file. Have you all been able to open the Writer file or no? If not, then you should watch the video again. So let us now begin today's class. In today's class, the revision practice that you will be doing will include the options New, Open, Recent Document, Save, Save As, and Export as PDF. You will be revising all of these submenus. Type out the paragraph being shown here and then practice one by one. Have you typed out the paragraph? Now you will save your file. If you have any doubts, Then watch the video and learn. Let us watch this video and see how we can save a writer file. In order to save our file, we first need to look for the file option which is at the extreme left on the top. Bring your cursor here and left click on the file option. A window opens. From this window, look for the save option and click on that. Once you click on that, another window opens and now you have to tell the computer the address where you want to save. So from here you can choose the desktop, which is where you want to save the file. Next, come into this area which is for the file name and type a file name. You can type your name or any name that you want to save the file with. Once you type the file name, go to the save option and click there. Your file gets saved and in the title bar, you will see that the file name is appearing. Watch the video and it is shown here in the left top corner, the file name has come. Also, since you have now saved this file on the desktop, you can minimize the file and look for the symbol for this file on your desktop. As is being shown in the video, this symbol is available here. So this way you can save your file. You can also use the shortcut Ctrl plus S to save. Do you know how to open a new file? You can also practice using the shortcut command. If you face any problems in opening a new file, then watch the video being shown and learn how to open a new document. Let us now look at this video and learn the use of the new submenu option of the file menu. Whenever we want a new page for our writer, when we want to work on something new, we will need a new page. To get the new page, we first have to bring our cursor or pointer to the file menu. You will see this in the video also. We bring our cursor to the file menu, left click on this, and a window opens. In this, look for the option, which is the very first option saying new. When you take your cursor there, you see another sub window opening, which has many options available. Take the cursor to the text document option and left click with your mouse or touchpad on the text document. You will notice that a new page opens. You can also use the shortcut command Ctrl plus N to get a new page. Whenever you are wanting to work on something new. Next, you will practice open. All of you, open a file which has been already saved in the computer. For open, you can also use the shortcut command Ctrl plus O. Again, if you face any problems in opening the file, then watch the video being shown to you carefully and learn. Let us now learn the use of the open submenu of the file menu. For opening a file which already exists on your computer, go to the file menu, click on it with your left button of the mouse or the touchpad, look for the open option and click there. Now you should know where your file is available. Is it on the desktop or in downloads or in recent places or in documents? We know that we had saved our file in the desktop. So in the address bar, you will see in the video, desktop is written. So you have to now look for your file within the desktop. For doing this, you can scroll up or down in the desktop and you can see your file is there. Click on that to select it and then click on the open option and your file will open. You can use the shortcut command Ctrl plus O to open your file. Let us now practice the use of recent document. Can you tell why we use recent document? By using recent documents, you can see those files on which you have done some work or you had opened the files. If you have any doubts about using recent documents, then watch the video and learn. With this video, we will learn how to use the recent menu, submenu of the file menu. To go to recent documents, we first have to take our cursor or pointer to the file menu. When we left click on this, a box opens and you have to look for recent documents option. When you take your cursor there, another box opens which shows many of the files that you have recently closed or worked on or saved. So take your cursor to the file that you want to work with and left click on that option. And the document that you are wanting to work with opens up. So this way you can use the recent document submenu. All of you practice the save as option by yourself. And also tell why do we use save as. If you face problems in this, watch the video being shown. Let us watch this video to learn how we use the save as option of the file menu. To use the save as, we use the save as option if we want to make any changes in our file and do not want to save it with the original file. We have opened a file which was already on the computer and now we are typing something additional in this writer file and now we do not want to save it where this file was originally saved. So we can change the file name and we can change the location of saving. To do this, we will use the save as submenu of the file menu. So we need to take our cursor to the file menu here at the top on the left side of our screen and click with the left button of the mouse or the touchpad. A window opens. You have to select the save as option and click there. Once you do that, a window opens. Now you can change both the location of where you want to save, the address, and you can also change the file name. So here you can change it from the address bar. You can change the location. So we are keeping the location as the desktop. And next we can change the file name in the file name bar here. So we change the name. You can type any name that you like. We are typing file save as and then click on the save option. You will notice in the title bar that the file has file save as. The name appears there and this has been saved as that file name with that file name on the desktop. Since we have saved it on the desktop, let us minimize this and look for the icon for our file, which is here, which is being shown in the video, file save as. You can use the shortcut command Ctrl plus Shift plus S to save as the file. Export as PDF. By using the export as PDF option, we can change the writer file to PDF. Now you need to show that you can change your file to PDF. If you have doubts in this, then carefully watch the video and then change your file to PDF. In this video, we will learn how we use export as PDF submenu of the file menu. So for using export as PDF, you first have to bring your pointer or the cursor to the file option, which is on the top left corner of your screen, and click here with your mouse or touchpad's left button. A box opens and you have to look for the export as PDF option. Click on that, and another box opens where many options are shown. Currently, you do not have to make any changes, but just have to take the pointer to the export option or the export button and click on that with the left button of the mouse or the touchpad. Once you click there, and a box opens which tells you where you want to save your file, so you can give a location and also change the file name to the file name that you want to save as. So just as we had used save and save as, here you can write a file name which you like and then click on save. Your file gets saved as PDF file. Now to check for that, we will just go ahead and minimize this screen by going to the top right corner and clicking on this button. Now look in the location where you have saved. So since you had saved on desktop, you can find the icon for PDF file. Double click on this icon and your file which has been saved as PDF will open up. You have to use the left button and double click. Now you see that the cursor is blinking in this file. But if you try typing anything, you cannot type anything because this is a PDF file. So this way you can export as PDF or change and save your file as PDF. Since we will be ending today's class now, all of you should close your writer file. And if you have any doubt about closing files, you must watch the video and learn. In order to close the writer file, so take your pointer or the cursor to the top right corner where there is a cross sign and click on that with the mouse or the touchpad using the left button. You see three options appearing in a window. Since you do not want to save right now, you can say discard, which is the middle option. Click on that with the left button of the mouse or the touchpad, and your file, writer file, gets closed. Next, shut down the computer, and if you face a problem, watch the video again. Let us now learn how to shut down your computer. Bring your pointer to the start button as is being shown in the video. Next, use your mouse or touchpad to click on the left button. A box appears and you have to look for the shutdown option and take your pointer there. Then, using your mouse or touchpad, click with the left button and this will make your computer shut down. In today's lesson, you have revised the options New, Open, Recent Documents, Save, Save As, and Export as PDF. Thank you.